Hi, welcome to an Inventor 2019 video tutorial. I want to do the front wing exercise now in Inventor. So, let's have some fun with Inventor. First, I want to create some planes. One in this direction, let's say 800 distance. Another one in that direction, maybe 60. Another one that direction, maybe 610. And another one in that direction, minus 610. Let's start with a sketch on that plane here. I start with a rectangle, and this could be 400 by 300. Okay. Now project as construction element that plane into the sketch, and then align these two, and I think it's switched H and V, the H and V direction, so we'll go for horizontal and align that midpoint with that point. Yeah, you cannot see that, but the rectangle's first dimension is usually the horizontal one, and here it was the vertical one, so those two are switched in this view. Okay, maybe switch this to construction, add an arc, maybe like this. Align those two points and that's there, so I go for a constraint here. Okay, give it a dimension, maybe that's 250. Now trim. And I suppose I lost that constraint. No, I didn't. So I think, yeah, you should align one point with this one and that point with that one. Okay, it's fully constrained, which is not necessary. And I want to have the fillets in the sketch, so go for fillet, make it 60. This is switched on, so they're all equal. You could go for 70 as well. Yeah. Finish that sketch. Then another sketch on the top plane. Okay, this sketch may look something like that. Close that one, yes. Now align those midpoints horizontal and give it some dimensions. This might be 150, this one may be 250, that distance could be 300, and now align this point and that projected origin point. Add some fillets, maybe 40, change this to 100 or 120. Yeah, finish that sketch. Let's make a loft. So go for a loft. I don't need the extrudes because I can go normal to the sketch profile, but I will use an extrude here anyway, so I can go for an extrude. Make an extrude in the other direction, make it, let's say, 20. Okay, that sketch should be reused. So share that sketch. Now go for loft from the smaller one. Sketch this one to that sketch over here. And now go to conditions. Go to like this, and then you can change the weight. So the weight should be 0.7. Yeah, this looks okay. And confirm. Hopefully I did add it. Yes, I did. Now make a fillet here, make it 20. Okay. Then a shell. I want to remove that face and make it in both directions, maybe 5 thickness. Okay, great. Next sketch on the XY plane. Okay, I need a circle, 30 diameter, a line. Could try to snap. Maybe like that. And then an arc. And I want it to be tangent, of course. And it should be also tangent to this direction. Okay, now trim that and change this if possible. So go for a dimension. Let's move this up if possible. Maybe over here. And if you want to see it, cut graphics. And this could be a little bit smaller. Maybe like that. Move it here, for example. Finish that sketch. Now let's go for an extrude with that sketch. Make it symmetric and between, or make it 2 if possible. Yes. But I need it in both directions. So make it 2. This one, that's not possible. Could I go for between this one and that one? That's possible. And okay. Next, another sketch on that plane again. Circle, again 30 diameter. Two arcs. Another arc. Make them tangent. And again, this might be like this. Make that for construction only. Trim. But that would make a problem, so I want to delete it because I want to move this up a little bit, maybe like that. Looks okay, move it up here, but try to select a contour. Okay. For example, like this. Finish that sketch, and I just noticed I should have put that sketch on that plane, but that doesn't matter, I will copy it. So copy this one and paste it just there on this one. And then I could hide for the moment the body. Okay. And now I could change this one and make this smaller. Maybe like that. Finish that sketch, that's okay. Now go for extrudes and new bodies. So, one extrude here. In that direction, new body, make it 80. Another extrude, another new body with that sketch. Turn it around, maybe again 80. Now I want a loft between those two, so go for loft, select that edge right here, select this edge over there, okay, and go for conditions and make it tangent, make it tangent. You could change the weight, 1.5. 1.5, yeah, this looks good. Okay, so let me see, this was added, so I want to combine those two. Okay, then mirror it, so mirror, I want to mirror that body right here, it's already selected. The mirror plane would be this one. And confirm, show the already existing body, looks pretty good. Now I need another sketch on that plane right here, and this should be something like, I will draw it over here. Okay. Maybe add another arc here. Usually I do it with circles, but you can do it with arcs in this case. trim. Add a fillet. And make it tangent. Trim. Let's try to move this up a little bit, maybe like this, okay. Then try to move this over here, maybe like that. Once again, move it up a little bit. Maybe like this. Finish that sketch, or just try to move this. Maybe like that, that's okay. Finish that sketch. Let's make an extrude. Add it. Let's see. We have to add it to some body. We'll make a new one. Just to see the direction. Go for 5. Add it to body. Yeah, so this is really odd. This version seems to have some problems. So the solid would be this one. Okay, then mirror that feature. This last feature, this extrusion with that plane, confirm, and then combine those two bodies, and okay. And I think I'm done. So let's hide the planes and the origin planes and the dimensions, of course. Yeah, I'm done. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook Cat fan page, and please like it over there. Would be very nice of you. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.